Good morning, ladies. My name is Teresa, and I go by the name of Blue Living Beauty. And we are here to talk about all things beauty. We know that beauty is on the inside, but we like to share makeup to enhance our beauty on the outside. And I just want to welcome you, and I want to thank you for subscribing or stopping by my video. And today is going to be a quick video, and I want to share with you this Barry Valentino foundation. I have the shade DN2. I've been trying out this foundation for a couple of weeks now, and I'm just going to go ahead and tell you, I've really grown to really like it. When I first purchased it, I thought it was the wrong shade, thought it was too dark. And I played around with it. I did some different things with it. And I think I've got it down pat. And I really like this foundation. The DN2, there is a big jump to, I think it's not DN1, I think it changes a whole nother category, which I was afraid that would be too light because the person that's wearing it does not look like me. So I learned how to use it. I'm going to show you what it looks like, and I'm going to get your opinion on what you think. I've already did my skincare, prepped my skin, put my sunscreen on. I have been using my Augustina and Batter Victoria Beckham Golden. Because it's kind of a matte foundation, I've been using this under it. And I like the way it feels throughout the day. I'm not in a rush to get my makeup off at the end of the day. My skin doesn't look irritated or stressed. Some of the foundations that I really love have that effect. This does have fragrance in it. The smell doesn't stick around, but you can smell a fragrance in it. The sunscreen is the Broad Spectrum SPF 26 Light Lasting Perfecting Foundation. And I believe this claim was a 24-hour claim, which nobody should take them up on that. And this says it expires in 2023. Now, not many foundations you get with a 2-year expiration. So I have been using my Charlotte Tilbury color corrector. I'm just trying to use up products that I have. I put this to the side for a long time, but I think it does okay. It's the number 2, and I really should have gotten a number 3. But I'm trying to use what I have. It's going to be a goal of mine. I love to try new products. And since I really started my channel to share and talk about complexion products, whether it's skincare, the health of your complexion, foundations. I think I have a lot to share, and I think I need to share those things before I just continue to keep purchasing things. There's so much we can purchase. You have to be careful. So what I've learned is I needed the slightest little dot I mean, not even a full pump. Not even a full pump. This goes a long way. So I am just going to dot that on my face. And I am going to, that is the only product I purchased from that line. So I'm going to go in with my Pat McGrath number 18. Yes, 18. And then I am going to take my Sonia G brush from the, which set was this? This is the jumbo base, the one I had to repurchase. This gives me just a light, even coverage. Always trying to work on my uneven skin tone. And I'm going to go right in with the same brush to blend my concealer. And I will go in with a second coat of the concealer with something smaller. But I just kind of wanted to blend this down and around my foundation. And I like how that looks. So I am going to put a little bit more concealer. And then I am going to just take a tiny bit of the Gerard Cosmetics Canvas Base. You only need a little bit of that as well. I'm going to use the same concealer brush. I think I use a small little pea, not even a pea, smaller than a pea, small little dot, and look how much this spreads. Wipe that off. And I got a surprise. I said, I never use my Pat McGrath under eye powder. Excuse my voice. So I was like, oh, I should use it for my eyelids because I feel like it's too drying for my under eye. Well, I opened it up and look what I found. A crumbled mess, and I was so upset. I don't recall dropping this, and I feel like I've seen someone else's who had the same problem. I've had it, I don't think it's been a year, but that was unfortunate. So I did dab some of the powder on the sponge just to dry that down. Okay, and then I am going to go in with a sponge, Beauty Bakery sponge, to tap out this concealer. Gonna take my Tatcha powder. Just going to take the Sonia Jean Mini Cheek and go under the eyes just to set that. If I get any oils anywhere, it is here around my nose. I really feel like I have normalized my skin. I really don't have a problem with dryness anymore. In the colder months, maybe, but I moisturize. Okay, so that is my base. I am going to go in . I guess I will use my LYS bronzer, and I have the color Courage Tan. I am a beauty ambassador with LYS. I will have my link below. If you want to purchase from the website and use my link, I will get a small commission from it. Or you can go straight to the website and order. It is a Black-owned brand. It is a fairly new brand. It is a clean brand. They are also sold at Sephora. And they have a variety of makeup products. And I have a video on their products. But I will be showcasing more of their products. And that is Courage Tan. All right. So for the eyeshadow, I'm not your eyeshadow enthusiast. I love eyeshadow, but I'm usually very basic and neutral. But I did get the new Pat McGrath Mothership number 9, and it is beautiful. I have been building my Pat McGrath collection, so I have 5 Motherships now, and 2 of her, I think, what is this, the 8-pan palettes? 6-pan palettes. And this is Color Story. Very pretty. It has this big, beautiful mirror. I didn't want to blind you, but it has what I need to make a neutral, everyday work look. This is the matte color Cosmic Bloom. It's a pink shade. It's kind of soft. It's not like boom in your face. You can build it up, but it's very soft. And for those ladies that do prefer a big punch of color, you know, you can build it up. And Pat McGrath on her Instagram, if you ever want to see looks on all different types of models, you can go to her Instagram and she'll show you. Her makeup artist will be showing how to use the different products. Now I'm going to go in with Shockwave and just to put a little shimmer and a little depth on the end. Not trying to do a whole lot. I did finally throw my mascara away. It was time. I'll reach over here and this is the Black Coffee Pat McGrath Eye Pencil. Just gonna do a little on the waterline. I'm going to go in with this Merit Eye Gel. Mascara. I'll move my stuff around trying to help myself. But it's not working. Okay. I'm just gonna use this Gucci mascara. So I was going through my makeup and I tossed Ilia, my Pat McGrath, and my Shanta Kai because they were at least 8 months old and I have used them consistently. So. Okay, and let's see. I've been wearing a mask. I do have some lipstick in my bag, but just gonna grab this lip gloss and can't see the color, I mean the name, but let's see if this works. This is what I bought it for. Okay, Dare to Bare Lust Gloss Lip Gloss, Pat McGrath. It's not as pink as it looks once you get it on. So I always put something on my lips because I do have to drive in a car. I didn't do any blush. I do have a LYS blush, and this is in the color Confident. It's a cream blush. So I'm just going to pop some of this on, and I'm going to show you throughout the day and at the end of the day how this foundation held up. All right, so you guys have a happy work day or home day, whatever you're doing today. Thank you for getting ready with me, and we're gonna just go all over with our Sephora Micro Smooth. And I will see you later in the day. Have a good day. Be blessed. Bye for now. So I hope this is not, the sun is not too bright. It's been almost 6 hours since I had on this foundation. And I really like it. And because I am going for a short walk, I wanted you to see it before. Well, I don't plan to be out here getting sweaty, but I just wanted to show you how it looked before I finished my walk. Just going on probably won't even be a mile because it's very hot out here. And what we do sometimes, some of the ladies that work in the family care programs, you get an extra 30 minutes if you want to do wellness. And our offices are within the junior military housing community. So we just walk through the community on our lunch break and pray you don't get chased by a dog, because everybody has a big dog. So just wanted to show you a wear test today, and this is the Valentino foundation that I showed you when I put it on this morning. All right, I will see you guys at the end of today. Make sure you get your exercise in a few days a week. It does wonders for the mental. So do something. Don't have to be a lot. Just do something. Set a step goal. If you can't do 10,000 steps, do what you can do. Set a goal. We gotta be beautiful inside and out And that means taking care of your health. All right, we'll see you later. All right, guys, it is the end of the day, and I wanted to come back and show you how my foundation looks. I think it looks pretty good still. I didn't do any touching up or anything. You can even still see some of the bronzer, a little bit of the blush, but you can see some of the bronzer still because I did have on a mask off and on today. So it naturally is gonna bring some of it off, but I think this foundation held up pretty well considering I did a little bit of exercise. Do see some of the, that's like rubbing against the mask is like a little textured and bumpy. I think that's more so the friction of the mask, but held up pretty good. One thing, I don't think I've shared this with you guys before, but this Sunday to Sunday product, it is a Black-owned product, and it's a hair gel. It says daily nourishing serum infused with biotin, and it's Edge Flourish. And I guess it's geared toward if you want to strengthen your edges. I use it all throughout my scalp. And I must say it's not greasy, it's not oily. I can put it on at night or in the daytime and it doesn't drip down. Like sometimes when I put down a oil, because I like to use oils in my hair, sometimes it'll kind of slip down across my forehead. But this says, this silicone-free formulation blends sunflower seeds, coconut oil, and provide a lightweight, flake-free formula that helps repair and strengthen your hair. The banana botanicals extract and biotin provides nourishment in touchably soft and strong edges. So, yeah, I've been using this for a while, but I like this product. And you just open that up and see the texture of it. It's like a gel. Yeah. All right. So this will wrap this up for this video tonight. And just wanted to show you what the foundation is looking like after 12 hours. And you guys have a good night. Until the next time. Stay beautiful and stay blessed. Bye.